So in one of my previous videos regarding Diablo 2 modding, I showed you how to merge several mods into one and start playing. And I know things can get messy when you do that manually and have to rely on precise step-by-step guides. But this time, actually, this guy named Olegbl, give him some credit, came up with a mod manager tool written in JavaScript, which will save you from manual labor and do all these routine steps in just a few clicks. Here I'll show you how to install this mod manager, where to find compatible mods, and share my feedback. So let's begin, shall we? The process of installing mods is almost identical. You find any mods like BetterSP or Mod Density, put them in your game folder, replay specific files, and then and launch the game with a certain command line arguments. With the mod manager, however, you can simply get the mods from nexusmods.com, for example, put them into the mod manager folder and install it. But here's one catch. To my knowledge, since this app is written in JavaScript, it uses a different mod format that can only be applied to the text files that can be overwritten on the go. Basically, it means you will not be able, at least for now, to copy and paste your favorite mods from the previous version, like the same old battle SP or Xander, and play it. It is simply not compatible with such mods that affect textures, models, and other visuals. Anyway, if you are still willing to try this tool, here are the steps as follows. First of all, open Nexus Mods page for this mod manager tool. The link can be found in the description. Go to Files, Manual Download, and download it. Keep in mind that you need an account for that. Then open this archive, drag and drop it to any desired place, preferably into your Diablo 2 folder. Launch the D2 mod manager exe file inside that folder, and then give the program the exact location of your game client. You can copy and paste the folder location from your explorer. Now all we have to do is to find some compatible mods for the mod manager. The list of some of these mods can be found on the same page where we downloaded this tool, in the requirements section. Grab any of these mods, their size is relatively small because these are basically scripts and configs. Same as before, open the archives and drag and drop them inside the mod manager mods folder, and then click refresh mod list, and bam, the list is now consists of the mods that we have downloaded before. On the left you can check or uncheck specific mods that you want to use, and on the right some mods can have a small gear icon for additional customization, in my case mob density. You can also drag these mods to change the load order if some mods in rare cases overwrite each other. Now it is time to merge these mods, so simply hit install mods. This will take some time, but it shouldn't take longer than a few seconds. Once your mods have been installed, you can run the game and test the new changes. It is that simple. But there are still some questions unanswered. If you want to launch the game via the shortcut, you can either create a shortcut to this mod manager or create one for Diablo 2 and then manually type this command argument in the target field. For Battle.net app, the process is almost identical. Go to D2, Options, Game Settings, then check the additional command line and type the same line here. After that, the game will launch with the mods merged by the mod manager. As for the save files, they are stored by default in this location. So if you wish to save your progress, just copy your save files from a different mod and paste them inside D2 mod manager folder. I would say there's still plenty of room for improvement regarding mods, and I believe many new mods or tools will simplify the modding process even further. But in its current state, this mod manager is not a permanent solution. If you wish to play global mods with the new UI or textures, you will still have to do this manually because the file system is different here. If you are fine with some minor tweaks like monster density or increased drop rates, then go for it. It's totally worth it. Well, that's all for now. I hope you found this video helpful. If you still have some questions, make sure to check out my in-depth guide on my website with the detailed steps and screenshots. And also don't hesitate to ask here in the comments, I'll try to help as much as I can. Thank you for watching and listening, please consider subscribing if you want to see more content on this channel. Have a nice day and stay safe.